Good morning students, welcome to Blue Stars Higher Secondary School. Today we are going to learn a new poem, Geography Lesson. This poem is written by Zulfikar Ghosh. The poet's name is Zulfikar Ghosh. He was born on March 13, 1935 in Pakistan. First we move to the introduction of the poem. The poem describes the poet's opinion of land below when viewed from the sky. He finds the earth the least attractive from above and continues going higher up. As the poet moves higher, he realizes that the country is full of cities and valleys. These are the hard words present in this poem. Inevitable, unavoidable, haphazard, having no plan, order, direction, sprang, move or jump suddenly, delineated, to describe something precisely. This poem describes the poet's opinion of the land below when viewed from the sky. He finds the earth the least attractive from above and continues going higher up. As the poet moves higher, he realizes that the country is full of cities and valleys. This made him realize that people are completely dependent on land and water for their existence. At one point of time, the poet also realizes that there is more water on earth than land. He also understands that there are many boundaries on earth that leads to hatred among people. First, I recite the poem, listen carefully. When the jet sprang into the sky, it was clear why city had developed the way it had. Seeing it scaled 6 inches to the mile. There seemed an inevitability about what on ground had looked haphazard, unplanned and without style when the jet sprang into the sky. In this poem, the poet describes his city when he was traveling in an aeroplane and he wonders how the city has been developed according to the people's needs by seeing through the window of an aeroplane. This is the explanation for the first stanza. Now I recite the second stanza. When the jet reached 10,000 feet, it was clear why the country had cities where the rivers ran and why the valleys were populated. The logic of geography that land and water attracted man was clearly delineated when the jet reached 10,000 feet. Now we will see this explanation for the second stanza. When the aeroplane reached 10,000 feet, then the poet understood the logic of geography. Why the countries had cities along the rivers and the valleys were populated as well. It is land and water together which attracts the men, which was clearly delineated in this poem. Now I recite the third stanza. When the jet rose 6 miles high, it was clear the earth was round and that it had more sea than land, but it was difficult to understand that the men on the earth found causes to hate each other, to build walls across cities and to kill. From that height it was not clear why. Now we will see the explanation for the last stanza. When the aeroplane reached 6 miles from the ground, the poet could see clearly the earth was round and it had more sea than land, as we know that earth is made up of 30% of land and 70% of water. But the poet can't understand the reason why the people living on earth hate each other, to build walls across cities and kill each other. That is the only thing the poet couldn't understand from that height. Which means the people living on earth don't have unity, so we must learn to lead a peaceful life without ego and hating each other. This is the moral of the poem. Today's assignment is read and write the hard words of the poem along with its meaning. Thank you, students.